Welcome to the explainer. Have you ever looked at the price of a government bond and wondered, where does that number actually come from? Well, it's not some big mystery. It's just math. And in the next few minutes, we are going to break down that math step by step so you can see exactly how it works. Okay, let's dive right in with our example. We're looking at a government bond with a 4-year term. It pays an annual coupon of 4.2%, but remember, there's a 25% tax on that interest. The principal, your initial investment, gets paid back at the very end. But here's the really important part. It's index-linked. That means its value adjusts for inflation, and it all starts from this base consumer price index, or CPI, of 145.11. So here's our game plan. We're going to tackle this in 5 parts. We'll start with the absolute basics of cash flow, then jump into pricing, see how time and inflation shake things up, and then we'll get into the really cool advanced stuff.
First things first, before we can calculate anything, we have to understand the money an investor actually gets to keep. This is the bedrock for everything that follows.
You know, it's crucial to get this distinction between what the government promises and what you actually get. The gross coupon is that 4.2%, but after the 25% tax man takes his cut, the net cash flow, the money that actually hits your account, is 3.15. And that net number? That's the one we care about. It's what we'll use for all our calculations from here on out.
All right, let's get into our first big calculation. This is where you'll see how price and yield are basically two sides of the very same coin.
Okay, so here's our first puzzle. Imagine other bonds out there, similar to ours, are giving investors a 1.8% return after taxes. That's our market benchmark. So the question is, what's a fair price to pay for our bond today if we want to get that same 1.8% return?
The whole idea here is something called present value. It's simple, really. Money you'll get in the future is worth less than money you have in your pocket right now. So to find today's price, we take all the future cash we're going to get, those 3 net payments of 315 plus that big final payment of 103.15 when we get our principal back, and we discount them using that 1.8% market yield. It's just a way of figuring out what they're all worth today.
And when you run the math, you get a price of 105.16. Now notice, that's more than the bond's face value of 100, and that makes total sense. Think about it. Our bond is paying a sweet 3.15% after tax, but the market is only asking for 1.8%. Our bond is a better deal, so investors are willing to pay a little extra, a premium, to get it.
Okay, let's flip this on its head. This time, we know the price. Someone is selling this bond for 102.8. So now our job is to figure out the yield. What's the actual rate of return you'd get if you bought it at that price?
So when we work backwards from that price of 102.8, we find the net yield, your actual take-home return, is 2.41%. Now, you might see the gross yield quoted, which is higher at 3.43%, but that's before tax. This is a perfect reminder to always, always focus on the net yield. That's the return that really matters to your wallet.
Of course, bonds don't exist in a perfect little bubble. In the real world, time passes and inflation happens. So let's see how those factors totally change the bond's price.
Okay, fast forward 2 years. We are now halfway through the bond's life. A lot can change in 2 years, right? The market's expectations have shifted, so the new net yield is 2.2%, and inflation has been busy pushing the CPI up to 151.2. So it's time to recalculate.
Okay, our first step is to figure out the bond's price based only on the cash that's left to be paid. Let's forget about inflation for just 1 second. With 2 years left, we have 2 payments to go. So we discount those future payments using our new 2.2% yield, and that gives us what we call a nominal price of 101.84.
And now for the magic of an index-linked bond, adjusting for inflation. We take that nominal price we just found and multiply it by a simple ratio, the new CPI divided by the original CPI from when we started. You can just think of this as scaling up the bond's value to make sure your money still has the same buying power.
And there you have it. The final inflation-adjusted price is 106.099. I love this because that one number perfectly captures both the current market expectations through the yield and the total effect of inflation up to this very moment.
Things start to get really interesting when you want to buy or sell a bond on some random day of the month, not on a nice, clean coupon payment date. So let's see how to do that calculation.
All right, let's get really precise now. What's the price on a random Tuesday where 3 years, 3 months, and 21 days into this bond's life? The yield has changed again, so has the CPI.
To figure this out, we've got to break it down into a few logical steps.
So the process here is a little different. First, we have to kind of travel back in time. We take that final payment and discount it all the way back to the last coupon date to see what it was worth then. Then we travel forward, compounding that value to add the interest it earned for the 111 days between then and today. And finally, we do our familiar inflation adjustment.
And after following that precise process, we get our answer, 107.27. That's the exact index-adjusted price on that very specific day, accounting for every single factor.
For our final calculation, let's tackle a situation that happens all the time, pricing a bond based on what's called accrued interest. This is the interest that's been earned day by day, but hasn't been paid out yet. If you're selling, you deserve to get paid for that.
So here we are, exactly a year and a half before the bond matures. What that really means is we are perfectly smack dab in the middle of two coupon payments, and we absolutely have to account for that half year of interest that's already been earned.
And the formula for this is actually really intuitive. We start with the principal. We add to that the net interest that's been quietly building up for the last 6 months. That gives us our total nominal value. And then we do our final step. We multiply that entire thing by our index adjustment factor to get the true up-to-the-minute price.
So what's the big takeaway from all this? Well, pricing a bond isn't some dark art. It's really just a logical process of accounting for four key ideas. 1, money today is worth more than money tomorrow. 2, taxes will always take a slice. 3, inflation is always trying to eat your returns. And 4, interest is earned every single day, not just on payday.
So, look, this was never just a math exercise. Truly understanding how an asset is valued is one of the most powerful tools you can have as an investor. It lets you cut right through all the market noise and start asking the right questions. So the next time you see a bond's price flicker up or down, instead of just seeing a number, you can ask yourself, is that because of interest rates? Is it inflation? Or something else going on entirely? Now you know how to find out.